Let's see. These tunnels are so old now, and I doubt anyone has them mapped correctly. Ah, but that's all right. It's all about the journey, isn't it, my dear? Why are you worried, my little mouse? You're worried for my safety. Do you think I cannot handle my little brothers? Don't you look away from me. Don't you dare. The moments where I can't see you are the moments that have caused me the most harm. Tell me, plainly, what is bothering you? You have a spine, and you've steeled it during every interaction you've had with me. Steel yourself once more, and speak. How peculiar it is to have someone care for my well-being so much that they'd call into question my absolute power. My ability to bring nations to ruin. I'm not even offended. That is refreshing. No, don't apologize, my sweet. Instead, tell me how you want me to spoil you. One moment. We can address your being a servant in a bit. For now. Hidden chambers in the walls of these tunnels, provided one has the magic to unlock them. Do forgive the mess. I've been having to bribe the cell dwellers to move things about for me. Yes, I do in fact mean the little silver man-eating monsters that do little else besides screech. Chatty fellows, but with a love of gold that supersedes their love of munching on little niece like you. Now, here we are. That is certainly a small mountain of gold, gems, weapons, and other luxuries in this nice, endless room. Do forgive me if you find anything reminiscent of a teenage boy discovering things. This was once my hatchling room, hundreds of years ago. Here, go on and stretch those little legs while I make some preparations. Let's see. Ah, excellent. The little devil's managed to recover every bit of my armor. And make it nice and shiny. Best avert your eyes, love, unless you want to see your king undress. Oh no, I already took off this ragged shirt. My muscles are just exposed in this lurid light from the fireplace. Whatever will I do now? Oh, come now. You've seen me nude plenty of times, haven't you? You were one of the bath attendants that served my brothers and me, no? While we wrestled and roared and fought each other in that delicate, rose-petal-kissed water. Did you have fun watching us, by the way? We do love to get the hell ball riled up by fighting naked. You all give us so much entertainment with your blushing and secret worshipping. Darling, why do you think we dragons love your kind so much? No, not humans. To hell with that. No offense, of course. No, I don't mean humans. I mean, well, from how you're glaring at me, I can see you already know what I'm about to say, don't you? And you hate that you do. My pretty little songbird. Don't call you that. But darling, that's what you are. Why do you think you have that incredible magic in your veins? You don't even know what a songbird truly is. Do you? You only know what those slavers and priests' robes taught you. And all your brothers and sisters just like you. They told you that you were a monster, didn't they? That the magic in you is a sin, and that you must be made to kneel and worship us. But why? Why the Obari dragon family? The most dangerous of the dragon royal families. An Obari can absorb magic in dangerous amounts. A songbird produces magic in dangerous amounts, but oh, you have to. You can't let that nasty farmer bring destruction down on those that you love. So, like a walking martyr set to burn on the pyre, you walk forward in a ball of cruel pain. An eruption made to chase the demons that want in, out. Simple as that. And there it is. A shift from shame to curiosity. How could I be so brilliant? A simple mouse like me. Let me show you. You have to trust in me, however, lest we both go up in a brilliant blaze of magic. Do you want to stay cramped in these cold walls, skittering about like your namesake, constantly in fear that a big old cat will snatch you? Or do you want to burn with me, while I drive fiercer men and women to their knees in your name? Come closer. Listen now. You see? You see what you are capable of now that this white-hot flame has coated us both. Feel that power in you, raw and vengeful. It's what caught my eye in the first place, you know. All the other songbirds, they cage up with their weak little songs. Well, they're nothing to the phoenix-like fury that rages in you. You are ready to have your name said in history. A songbird is a shield to a farmer's sword. It's a struggle that has been going on for eons. Two legendary figures, reincarnated to battle, or to spy on each other, or to make love with extreme prejudice, over and over. But not all songbirds are true. After all, there can only be one at a time. How do I know any of this? The Shadow King himself told me. Funny fellow. Constantly shape-shifting, much like a real shadow. Voracious appetite for human flesh. I believe his sister came to scold him last time, as I haven't spoken to him since. Or maybe she was his lover. Who knows? I don't think they did. Oh, and if you see a surly young woman with a black cat about, try not to look her in the eye. Between you and I, of all the shadow royalty I've met, the little one is the scariest. Came pretty close to taking my head off with a scythe that screamed for the souls of the damned. Always the short ones that try and kill you when you call them adorable. I can't help it, though. I'm over 8 feet tall, dear. Everything is simply adorable to me. Or murderable, I suppose. We both burn so beautifully with you in my arms, don't we? Yes, my king. Oh, that does send shivers to all the right parts of this old body. Come now. It's time to prepare yourself.
To prepare for war?
No. No, darling. To prepare for me. I don't want to rip you in two, you know. There's a bath in that room there, my dear. Feel free to freshen up.
That was quite the cute little sneeze. Just from my tail flicking near your nose.
Don't worry, my pet.
Take your time.